Okay.
Denise is not here.
No, she's not here anymore.
Action.
Welcome, everybody, to the Hampton Municipal Budget Committee meeting on March 20th. If you would, Barbara, perhaps you would honor us by leading us in a pledge of allegiance, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
So, if you would, please introduce yourself, starting with Brian.
Brian Lapham.
Brian Warburton.
Regina Barnes, Board of Selectmen rep.
Stephen LaBranche.
Mike Bluff.
Jones.
David Maurer.
Bob Ladd, Village District Representative.
And we have Barbara Kravitz with us as our minutes recorder. I want to thank Danielle Augustine, Steve Henderson, and Sonny Kravitz for their service on this board, this committee, sorry. And I want to congratulate Mike Pluff on his reelection and Brian Warburton for his for getting elected to this committee as well. So what we're going to do next is we're going to reorganize, as we do every year at this first meeting after the election. Now, I have been the chairman this past year, and I want to thank everybody for their help. It was my privilege and honor to have that position. I am not going to, I don't wish to be nominated again this year. I think that I've served a year, and perhaps somebody else would like to have that opportunity. So, having said that, I'm going to open nominations for the chairmanship. Is there a somebody want to make a nomination, please? I'll nominate Tim Jones. Do I have a second? Seconded by David Moyer. Barbara, any other nominations for chair? Seeing none, those in favor of making Tim Jones the chairman of this budget committee, please raise your hands. We have David Moyer, we have Mike Pluff, we have Steve LaBranche, and we have Regina Barnes and Brian Warburton. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And those opposed and those abstaining. We have Brian Lapham abstaining, we have Tim Jones abstaining, and we have Bob Ladd abstaining. So thank you very much.
Yes, ma'am. Can I say one thing in regards to that?
Yes.
Congratulations, because I know he was also nominated last year, so I see it fit that you are willing to do it and you are nominated this year. And thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
So now that we've done.
Who was the second there?
David Moyer.
David Maurer.
Maurer. Maurer, sorry. I studied German in high school and in college.
Well,
and
actually, in German, they don't spell it. They don't pronounce it Maurer.
How do they pronounce
it more like Maurer.
Oh.
I was told that from a friend of mine who
okay,
was
well, whatever.
A German concentration
I'll try to remember
camp.
That.
All right.
That's why I don't
so,
do it.
If you would like, Tim, we'll swap chairs. How does that sound?
If you wish.
All right. And then
leave the agenda there, please.
You can continue with the nomination for vice chair. Okay. Congratulations. So,
all right, nominations for vice chair.
I'm going to nominate Stephen LaBranche for
second.
Vice chair.
Oh, second.
Any other nominations?
Oh, what?
No other nominations?
Third.
Okay.
I'd like to nominate Mike Pluff.
Second on that?
Second.
Okay.
Do you wish to accept that nomination?
I can or I could.
It's up to you.
None.
It's up to
if you. If you prefer to have it, that's fine.
Tim asked me if I would help him through the transition for the first year. So that's.
I have to remain neutral on this.
I know. I'm just saying. You asked me, and I'm telling you.
It's up to the body.
The will of the committee.
Do we have any other nominations? Seeing none, I would invite both nominees to speak to their candidacy, if they wish.
Go ahead, Mike. Well, I've been here several years. It's nice to have somebody that can pick up if they have to and keep track of what goes on and what needs to be done and when. And everything goes smoother if you have a little help. That's it.
Steve?
I've been here several years as well, and I'm fine with Mike being the vice chair right now. Okay, I'm fine with it. But let's see who votes for what, and we'll go from there, because I'm very comfortable. Mike has been, when he was the vice chair, he was always a help for me, and I leaned on him very much. So he certainly knows the ins and outs of this game and this town as well, certainly a lot better than myself. So in any case, that's all I have to say. Thank you very much.
Now, you were chairman for 1 year of the Budget Committee, right?
Yes, that's
and
correct.
And, Mike, you've been vice chairman for how many years?
Long time. I don't know, off and on.
Three or four or five, what?
At least.
I can't remember.
At least.
Okay.
The good vice man.
All right, so all those in favor of Steve LaBranch being the vice chair, raise your hand, please. All those in favor of Mike Plouffe, please raise your hand, please. Uh-huh. I guess you are continuing to be the main vice on this body.
You got the votes.
Thank you.
Thank you, and okay. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay.
We have approval of minutes for February 20. You have a motion on that, please?
I'll move.
I'll second it.
Thank you. Any discussion? All those in favor? Are unanimous, with the exception of Brian, who's abstaining.
Yeah.
Selectmen's update / report.
Well, we made it through the election. I was very glad to see that the contracts got passed and the wastewater treatment plant. To be honest with you, I think everything else was not important as those things, so I'm happy to see them pass. And we did not reorganize last night because we felt that with all the times Rick Griffin did serve as the selectman, he should be there for the reorganization. So we will be doing that next week. And I have decided not to accept any nomination for chairman because I feel like some legwork hasn't been done yet. So I will keep the board updated on that, and hopefully I can bring some new ideas to the selectmen and get some independent knowledge from outside this town to see how we can maybe better ourselves. And that's it for now.
Questions or discussion on the selectman's report?
Is there any update upon the PCB thing?
On the
water?
Oh, actually, they're coming in April 2nd for an update. I did receive the report, and as far as Aquarian Wells go, there is no significant changes. It's remained level the whole time they've been testing it. So they are going to come in, though, and figure out what the short-term action plan would be if it's needed, and when it's needed that they need to turn well 6 back on. They obviously would like to do some type of a treatment before they just let that water out into the system. And then they're also going to talk about possibly being able to implement well 22 right before peak time. So they're going to have that all in a report and present that on April 2nd. So.
Thank you.
Hi, Steve.
Regina, I saw in today's Portsmouth Herald that they did some testing for our own landfill.
Oh, yes, the monitoring wells in the landfill.
Yeah,
we
and they found
about
some
that.
PCBs there as well. I was kind of surprised because I thought that was like a big, they put everything in a big.
Well, most
bag, remember?
Has no bottom in it.
Yeah, they didn't put
oh,
the
really?
Bottom. Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Bottomless.
It only has a top.
I thought it was all contained in a big bag. Okay.
But
that's
that was
the explanation.
Over the top.
Okay.
That was just done as our regular monitoring, but per the recommendation of both the town manager and the deputy town manager, they wanted to add the PFC testing in with that as well.
Right.
So you know, the Board of Selectmen through town management was very proactive in having that added, and it will continually be tested similarly the way that Aquarian is. You know, I don't think it's going to be monthly, but whatever the requirements are,
yeah,
they will continue monitoring that And there's a little difference because it's not in the actual drinking water, but, I mean, still it's floating around, so. I mean, it would be nice if all the closed landfills in the state would do that and be transparent about it, but that doesn't seem the case right now, so.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
Anything else on the selectmen's report? I'll note that last night you discussed Article 44, and it was proclaimed to be advisory only. Is that correct?
Is that for the Sunny?
Yeah, it was referred to as the Kravitz motion.
Yeah, that's what I was going to call it.
But it was Article 44, actually.
Right. Yeah, well,
that was
think
the one that said that there would be a limitation on raises unless approved by town meeting.
Right, and we, for right now, deemed it to be advisory because it's in violation of RSA 37?
I think it was 236, he said, wasn't it? Something like that?
It's the town manager RSA. I'm not sure what the number is, saying that he has the authority for that.
I recall the percentage in favor of that was like 3-2, I believe, like 2/3 voted for it, something like that. It might have been higher, I don't remember specifically, but it was rather large.
And a lot of people voted for the non-smoking, too, which is all fine and nice, but, I mean, how is it going to get enforced? I mean, I think littering of a cigarette should be enforced, but other than that, it's going to be pretty difficult.
One's a limitation on the general public smoking, and the other's a limitation on politicians that spend money. There's a difference, in my mind, between those two in that respect. It is advisory. I'm wondering how much weight this body should place on that advice, in your opinion.
Well, I think that we should all wait, both this committee and the Board of Selectmen, until we have conducted we're going to do sort of like an organizational chart from town manager down.
Uh-huh.
All the departments,
okay.
Who's worked there, how long. I mean, I'm assuming it's going to show this information. I hope it does. When's the last time they got hit? How long have they worked here?
Mm-hmm.
You know, some of our hourly employees, I mean, no one's taking the jobs. These people are leaving, and no one's coming to fill the positions because the wage is so low. So we need to look at it more of in a broad picture, I think, and rather just like debating whether or not we're going to give a 1% overall or 1.5% or a 2% or whatever it is. But I think it needs to be done more that way, more broader, and bird's eye view of the whole organization.
That's the selectman's view or your individual view?
Well, that's what the town management's working on to prepare to give to the selectmen.
Okay.
I think that's
Jamie,
way to go.
Deputy town manager is, in charge of all that human resource. So he will be preparing that and giving it to the board at some point, I'm told, in April. So we're hoping to have, not drag out like we did last year, so.
Wayne.
Okay, village district report.
Now that the town or elections have been completed, the village district will have its election on the last Friday of this month, which is March 30th. The voting is from 1 p.m. to 7 p.m. at the Beach Firehouse. The meeting itself will commence at 7 p.m. Only people who are residents of the district and registered to vote within the district can vote on the articles that will be presented. This has to be distinguished between people who are residents of the town and registered to vote in the town. Unless you are registered in the district, you cannot vote in the district. However, we have a very liberal policy about anyone who wishes to attend to speak to a particular issue that is being presented. In that case, you do not have to be either a resident or a voter of the district. We encourage as many people as would like to attend. It is a form of government. The other thing we are considering for the voters is a theme week, which would be a country music theme week this summer. That's not in concrete yet, but work has been done preliminarily on it, and whether or not it comes to pass will be determined by the vote at our village district annual meeting, which will provide funding for that if it is approved.
Any questions on the village district report? Steve?
Not a question, but a comment. I just want to mention that the village district had its monthly meeting last Wednesday, and
something that I brought up to them that happened regarding this committee this past year, and I wasn't aware of it until after it happened. We had our meeting, you might remember, on February 20th with the Village District Commissioners. And the Budget Committee approved both of their warrant articles, the money warrant articles. But I didn't find out until days later that the Village District, and it was only because I happened to call the moderator, was the deadline for petition warrant articles to the Village District was February 27th. So what could have happened, there could have been a money warrant article. And I mentioned this to the commissioners at the meeting last Wednesday, because if somebody had come in with a petition warrant article, we would have had to have scheduled another meeting and another public hearing. And I just want to mention it to you, and you know, while Bob's here as well, so that when you go to make the schedule next year with Christina, you might want to make sure that you don't, that doesn't happen again. Now there are a certain amount of days after that public hearing before you can have the actual Village District meeting. So it's got to be coordinated, okay? Just wanted to let you know, okay? Thank you very much.
Anything else on the Village District report?
No.
Okay. The school district, SAU 90 representative is not here, so we will forego their report. Other business, anyone? I have a few items here. Mostly it's got to do with the calendar. And training, for example, we normally do something for training every spring. Is there any thoughts on approaching training for us as a group on the budget process? In the past, we've had NHMA in here give us for a couple of years. They gave us some training. Last year, they had a dog and pony show with the selectmen on RSA 91A.
91A stuff, yeah.
Nothing to do with the budget process. Personally, I'm disinclined to. Did you like that, Virginia?
If the town isn't going to use the money for the NHMA, then I suggest we keep, you know, we use it if possible.
So Brian makes a good point. I mean, we pay something on the order of $17,000-$18,000 a year in dues to the NHMA, also known as the New Hampshire Municipal Association. But in that's totally under the control of the Board of Selectmen. Even, I guess, beginning last year, or it might have been a year and a half ago, the selectmen restricted everyone's access to NHMA,
right,
unless they went through a fresh protocol of going through this filter to the selectmen and wherever. Part of the dues, that $17,000-$18,000 dues that we pay, we're entitled to the town is entitled to one free seminar on whatever topic of choosing. We don't know whether the selectmen are going to use that or not. Until the Budget Committee discovered this feature a few years ago, it was never used at all. And I don't know if the selectmen have any plans to use it. I would suggest they do have plans to use it, because it's just a wasted resource if you don't make use of the resource. From our point of view, from my point of view at least, we've had them in a few years already. There's really nothing new that I'm aware of relative to the budget law. It's pretty much been the same. Anyone disagree with that? Budget law hasn't changed in the last year, 2 years.
Yeah.
And we've got the video of their previous engagements. There's no reason to waste a seminar having them come in again when we can just present the videos right here, perhaps by topic, and have a discussion among ourselves as to the meaning, which would be something unique and less boring, I think, because when they were here, they basically do the percentage, and we don't have an opportunity to talk until after they're done, and even then, there's a certain challenge in doing that. But if we present the video by topic that we find some point of needing to to get a common understanding among ourselves, and if we can't raise the question, then we can raise that question through the protocol to NHMA and get that resolved. Does that sound like something that would be more desirable? You like that, Brian? Yeah. Okay.
I think that, I think as well, the last year, Christy gave everybody, or made it available to everybody, a copy of the book that's handed out.
Mm-hmm.
They have a, do they still, I imagine budget they book, still yeah. have that yearly meeting over in Manchester or something.
September,
that,
yeah.
Is it September?
Mm-hmm.
But whatever the case, I have a copy of that book. It was given to me by Eileen Latimer because the last time anybody went to that. And it covers everything about budgeting. It's very thorough. The Christy made copies off the copying machine and made them available to everybody here. I haven't read that book in several years, but it's worth another read. I think that in addition to running the videos, I would be willing to as well reference in the book what perhaps whatever topic there is they're talking about, and then if there's anybody has a question, I can say, okay, this is what the book says. Of course, you've got to realize that the New Hampshire Municipal Association, that book, it goes over the actual RSAs, but then there's a lot of, I think, opinion as well in the explanation part of it. And of course, the opinion is a lawyer's opinion, which of course can be, you know, there's always, if you ask, you know, two lawyers a question, you get three answers. So it's, but I would be willing to, I think, incorporate, because to review with the book as well and kind of bring both things together might actually be beneficial for us. I would like to sit down and read that book again, but I don't always have the time. But I think it might help all of us if we kind of incorporate the two things. It's just an idea, just throwing it out there.
Any other thoughts, Dave?
Fine with me. I think education is always helpful, and particularly even refreshing, because you forget after a while. Yeah. But I do remember reading parts of that book and getting people's various opinions. Then it starts getting confusing. That was my interpretation of some of it.
I think more information is always beneficial. Yeah. It's funny, 20 years ago, the NHMA conference was actually in November. I think it's still in November, but that's a good point because, you know, laws may or may not have changed, but information gets updated. And like Steve mm-hmm. said, I think it's great to have copies of anything that's going to benefit us going forward or any mm-hmm. any time that we can be reviewing the RSAs. I have a bulk of information myself, but I'd be interested in seeing the updates. I think it's great.
Well, perhaps one of the questions we can ask NHMA through Regina is what has changed in the budget law since they were here 2 years ago?
Yeah, that would be.
And that way, when we do it, we'll have that in mind. If anyone has any particular, I don't want to play the whole video because it lasts an hour.
Yeah, I know.
And I don't think we want to spend the time sitting here watching it.
Yeah.
But I think there are certain areas that you guys want to focus on that may be, you know, a little fuzzy or you want to magnify.
I would like to see the whole video, if it's only an hour.
Well, I'll make it available for your homework. How's that?
Right.
Yeah, right.
I will.
As a group.
I'll make it available to everyone as a group. But
right.
When we're in the meeting, I think we should focus on areas that are of concern or are not clear or you would like to have emphasis placed on for the group to have. To keep the meeting as effective as possible.
I'm thinking of even something a little bit better than that in my mind.
So you're saying play the whole video and like pause it as someone wants to make a comment or something?
That would be it, but also it's not even a public meeting. I'll make this up. We come in at a Saturday for 1 hour. We go from 2 hours because then we could find out what we're all strong in, what we're weak in, and then we can get topics from there. And if we did it as a group, it might be more beneficial listening to other people's thoughts at the time. Versus when you're home alone or whatever, watching it. I think there's power in teamwork. So just
you
a
want,
thought.
You want basically a non-camera meeting to go over the whole video, is what you're
yes,
saying?
Yes, Absolutely. It's only an hour, then an hour after to discuss what you like, and then we can put a list together which ones we want to go in more depth on.
For a subsequent on-camera meeting?
If you want it on camera or off camera, I don't care one way or the other.
Okay. Any thoughts on Dave's idea?
Yeah.
Gina?
Well, if I talk to whoever has to talk to NHMA, I'm not even quite sure, but I'll see if perhaps maybe they have, you know how they pass out the pamphlet that's like...
Right, that's what he was referring to.
But the update, an updated one.
Yeah.
Cool, right, cool. That's great, yeah.
And then, you know, because they must be doing those same conferences this year, so I'm sure that would have anything that...
Yeah.
And then we don't need them to come, but can they supply us with that stuff?
Any thoughts on Dave's suggestion? Do you like the idea of having a...
I personally don't think I'm going to be too happy to come in on a Saturday, so...
Just a thought of Saturday, make it a weekday.
Well,
unless
you,
well, a lot of, some people work.
What I'm suggesting is...
Some people work.
Still, don't forget, not all of us are retired.
This time of year, our load is light. So there would be no reason for us to have it on a Saturday.
It was only a thing to have it in here.
Yeah, we can do it at
just a regular,
some
night,
regular
right?
meeting
yeah.
because
that'd be better. I think.
That way, it is taped, and we can all sit here and discuss it in our regular meeting. Because there's generally times in the next couple months when we won't have much.
Right. Wait, one second, David.
Quiet.
I want to find out. You're suggesting that David's proposal of a Saturday meeting actually be an on-camera regular monthly meeting. And if we find it necessary to drill down at a subsequent meeting, we'll just have a subsequent meeting for that. Is that what you're saying?
We'll just have it, yeah.
Does that make sense?
Well,
it's a hybrid of your idea.
I think Brian is a very good point, is the fact it's very slow. So I'll make another silly example. You can cut it in half. We take it to one of these meetings, and we spend half an hour, or we spin it into quarters. But at the end of four meetings, we'll have covered the whole thing. We'll all have done it as a group. So if that works, I'm just proposing different ways to do it. I just would like to do it together.
It's an interesting idea. I think that makes sense. Does it make sense to you, Steve?
Do
it at regular meeting time.
Yes, definitely regular meeting, and I think it needs to be televised. I don't think we should be meeting and having non-public meetings. I think we should be in front of the camera, and the public should know and see what we're doing, and perhaps they'd like to learn as well.
Mm-hmm.
They might pick up something.
Okay.
One thing about just showing the whole thing, you know, when you take a regular meeting and you slice it up in little pieces and then you label the little pieces, I like that because it's targeted. I think I'd prefer that rather than just running that same, you know, the tape that for a full hour or just to keep interrupting. I'd rather have little chunks like you do and we can, because you can send them ahead of time to all of us.
Mm-hmm.
And if anybody has time or a special one that they want to look at, they could look at it at home, and it's broken up. So you don't have to watch the whole meeting to get to where you want to see one specific thing. That's, you know how he, does he send you those slices?
Yeah.
Yeah, you like that? Because I like it. I think it works very well.
Yeah.
It's just a thought.
Well, that was what I was suggesting, Dave, earlier, rather than play the whole video, is I send you guys the whole video, and then you can indicate to me any particular slices that you would have me make for the actual meeting. But you bring up a good point. Watching it from start to finish also has value. I think that everyone here has been around a long time in the budget process in one form or another and may not find it desirable, and that's why I was suggesting that we target it to a specific topic. So I'm totally open as to what the body wants to do on that point. I'm happy to hear that you guys want to do that kind of training. That's all I'm happy about. So, Steve?
There was more than one meeting. That's the thing. I mean, there was more. They were here more than once. They were here last year. They were here the year before.
Well, last year doesn't count because it was in Thailand 91A, and I'm only talking about budget process.
Okay, but if you wanted to put a little piece of that in as well, you know, you could put maybe a slice of 91A. I don't know. Maybe somebody wants to talk about that as well. I don't know. All I'm saying is there was more than one. Okay. I know we talked plenty about it before. Never mind.
Actually, on the very topic, after that gentleman talked, I went a month later to their presentation in Stratum, and it was an all-day meeting on 91A or whatever the official name is. So I got an hour here, and I got 8 hours over there. from all the different towns that wanted to come in, join. It was very good. But it was an entire day and a lot of discussion back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
It was really good in that sense. It was just one thing that, forget what it was at the end, we couldn't overrule it. But basically, it was very well done, and the gentleman did in the morning, and another lady came in the afternoon who was just as good as he was, and was very thorough and very knowledgeable. It was fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
But that was just that one topic, and it was 6 hours. So we're talking here 1 hour, and then trying to split it into pieces of maybe half an hour, one session or 15 minutes.
Well, again, I was talking about only dealing with the budget process, not 91A. If you guys want to do a similar thing on 91A.
No, I don't. I'm just using that as an example. They gave a great talk on that particular thing, and there's probably other things we can go to.
We'll stay on the budget process.
But that was on my own time on a Saturday.
So let's stay on the budget process.
With everybody else who went, there were a lot of different towns went.
So have we got a sense of the body here? Do you want to do the full video of the prior NHMA presentation on the budget process, or do you want to target specific it with me sending out the entire video to you guys and indicating what kind of slices from there you would like to emphasize for our actual meeting? How would you prefer it?
I will with number two.
I do two. I'm two.
Yeah.
I'm two.
You too?
So also.
You too.
All right, I will send out the entire video. I believe they were here 2 years in a row. Mm-hmm. I'll send out both of those entire videos. You guys indicate from there which ones that you would like to have me slice up for presentation at our subsequent meeting. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Sounds good.
Okay. Last year, as you guys know, when we made motions relative to the budget, we made them rather differently than we had for decades, because we were actually making motions related to legal line items, that is to say, the line items as defined by the Department of Revenue Administration, also known as DRA. So we used their line items last year, and during the course of that fun exercise, I had conversations with Christy, and she and apparently the town manager agreed that that was the right thing to do. And so they're reorganizing, or she told me she was going to reorganize the budget book next year, being this year, to reflect the one-to-one mapping with the DRA line items. Everyone understand what I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I think probably having maybe Christy in on that to tell us the implications of that might be a good idea. Any thoughts on that?
I'd like to know what's going on. Absolutely.
Yeah, okay. I think also we probably need and should be well advised as to all of our finances. And as long as we have Christy in here, we can have her present the status of all of the various funds we have, the trust funds and other funds. That makes sense? Anything else you'd like to have Christy speak to when we do invite her in, assuming she accepts coming in? Anything else?
So we're going to have a fun day.
Well, it's just going to be informational. I don't consider it debate or anything like that. So it's fun because it's informational, absolutely. Education should always be fun. Brian?
Oh, that's good. I love it.
Okay. And anybody else? Okay. Thank you for that. Let's see. So as the chairman, what I'm going to do, by the way, is, unless you guys object, is I will... be seeking a meeting with the town manager and trying to make sure that our interaction between the town manager and subsequently other entities under his realm are as smooth as possible. I will be trying to organize that so that Mike Plouffe, my vice chairman, will attend, and so I'll have that wisdom with me. And I will report back to you at a subsequent meeting. So I'll be looking forward to making that meeting as soon as possible, as soon as we can coordinate it. And that will probably result in me meeting others, such as Christy, for example, to make organization for that meeting. And so no one objects to that, I assume. Okay, cool. Any other thoughts, Steve?
We're still doing, what part of the agenda are we on, Tim?
Other business.
Other business, okay. I wanted to mention, I forgot to mention it when I was still sitting where you are. This is the condensed version of the Municipal Budget Committee. The process of
of reducing the size of this committee has now been finished.
Yes.
So there are, we've gone from 12 elected members to at-large members to 6 elected members. So this is the size that it will be from now on. Only Ginny is, only the school person is missing, but this is basically the size of the room. So we've gone from a big 15 people, which was a big group of people, down to 9, and it's, I think it's very manageable. I think this is, I think we're gonna get a lot done this year, so just wanted to mention that.
I think it does offer some challenges as well. I mean, it's easier to manage a smaller group, of course, but it's also easier to not have as diverse a thought process, you know, as you do with 15. You have a lot of opinions being thrown out there. So I hope that we can, you know, try to, you know, expand our thinking, knowing that we have to represent a broader constituency than was represented in the past, as was represented in the past.
So, I think, too, it behooves the public to get in touch with us if they have budget questions or anything to do with the budget. Now they need to step up and let us know what their thoughts are.
That brings up a good point, Brian, and it also raises another question in my mind. As a regular member, I always raise the question of what about rules, because we want to play by rules, and I didn't bring that up tonight, but maybe, do you guys want to have a discussion on it, or you just want me to come in and proclaim what the rules will be? How would you guys prefer it?
Proclaim.
We didn't do a lot of rules last year. Mm-hmm. We only had a couple. I think that... I'm in favor of minimizing the amount of rules.
Mm-hmm.
We don't need no stinking rules. just keep
spoken
it
like
keep
an
it to a, you know, exactly. just keep it to a minimum, Tim. Let's just keep this simple.
Well,
simple
we do
process.
Need rules, even if they're simple rules. And the issue is whether or not you guys, as a body, want to establish those rules, or you want me to come in and proclaim them. I don't think it's appropriate for me or anyone else to make up rules as you go along. Because that just leads to undesirable situations.
Well, how about you make up your list as tentative, and then we review them together?
Is that preferable for everybody?
That sounds fair.
Okay, good. All right, I'll throw that in some meeting during the spring.
Because 14 years ago, we tried Robert's rules.
No, forget Robert's rules.
And that's exactly what we did. By the third meeting, it was done.
It's way too complicated, and there are too many variations of it. In any case, any other business from anybody?
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Seeing no other business, I declare this meeting adjourned.
At
this time.
You want to make the note for Barbara?
Sure. It's like, what is the time, is it, Barbara?
7:38.
7:38.